Hey guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we are checking out the Cedar Creek Silverback Edition 29RE. Cedar Creek is specifically geared for your experienced RVer, somebody who may have already owned a few campers already. The reason for that is because their construction is higher quality, their insulation, this is also something that somebody might end up using this on long-term trips, something maybe they want to use it full-time or maybe for a couple months at a time. This is what level of quality you'd be looking for. Let me explain what that level of quality is on the outside and then we'll go into the inside. To start off, this camper weighs about 10,700 pounds dry and has a 14,000 pound GVWR. That means you can fit roughly around 3,300 pounds worth of stuff in the camper, which is plenty even if you're going to go on a long-term trip. Over here, this is your auto level system. There is a specific way that you unlock this so that nobody can just come up and do it. So I think it's either these two or these two, but it's all in the owner's manual and right here if you forget. The auto level system is one of those features that people appreciate a lot because if you have to level it two ways, right? Front to back this way and side to side, and sometimes it's all of that at the same time. By having an auto level feature on there, it will not only level out the coach automatically for you, but you will also have a more stable coach once you're parked in position. Back here, you'll notice that you have a large pass-through storage and all your connections. So you'll notice all your dump valves are enclosed inside the underbelly, easy access to be able to winterize your system, battery disconnect so you don't drain your battery. This is a hydraulic system, so it's nice that they have these little knobs here. What that does is instead of having to push one button to get all the slides in or out, you can individually control which slide you have going. This is called an easy reel. This is where your cord goes to, so you wrap your cord on there. It makes it a lot easier because it's not all nice and neat after the first couple times you use it. While we're under here, I also wanted to show you, look at how it has the L brackets over here and the screwed in, and it has some Siliprene behind there. That's super important because the way most coaches are built is they are welded together. Now, welds are fine until you start bending them back and forth and jolting them and vibrating. That over time can be bad for campers, right? It's like a mini earthquake for your house. By doing that, that gives you a lot of strength and flexibility as you're moving down the roads. This water heater is a 10 gallon capacity. This is a gas electric DSI water heater. So what you do is you push a button right here to turn it on, and you can run both the gas and the electric at the same time, giving you a total of 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour. This is set up with a 50 amp connector. That means you can run two ACs at the same time if you want. And you'll notice also the access for the furnace is a giant spot here instead of just a small spot. That means if you need to work on something in the furnace, you can take just four screws out and be able to access it very quickly. Two, you'll notice that this is a fully enclosed underbelly, but not only that, it's not just the white or the plastic corrugated stuff. These are actual panels, so if you have a problem underneath there, you can take down just that one panel instead of the entire underbelly, again, saving on your labor costs. You do have a rear ladder for easy access on top of your slide outs, as well as a backup camera already pre-installed. And you have a little tiny LCD monitor that goes into the truck and that you can just pop onto the windshield or however you want to do it. And those sync up, and then you can actually see people pulling up close to you, behind you, not just when you're backing up. Up here on top of the roof, I wanted to show you a few things. One, you'll notice that there's two cathedral slide outs, one for the bedroom and one for the living room. That's super nice, not only for extra room inside the coach, but also if something falls on those slide outs, it's gonna more easily roll off. Two, you'll notice this also has ventilation in the ceiling. That's not on most coaches. That's important though, just like your attic, it needs ventilation to be able to breathe. Two, you'll notice this is a TV antenna that is permanently mounted to a certain height that you don't have to worry about cranking that up and down. And then as we look over here, I wanted to show you that this is already pre-installed with the cables to be able to put solar in up here. So if you wanted to be able to put lots of solar panels, you can do that, and that will cut down the labor dramatically, just being able to plug right into there. And then if you decide to put a satellite dish up here, again, it's already pre-ran right here where this sticker is, so that you can easily just peel off the sticker. The hole's already pre-drilled. You just have to push through the rubber membrane and you're set, ready to add cables. Another thing that you'll notice about Silverback is they have the frameless automotive window. So if you look at this coach over here, you'll notice it has a piece of rubber right here that can dry and crack out and shrink over time, whereas this one you don't have to worry about that. Also, these are rain windows, so they pivot from this middle point and open up. That way, if it starts to rain, it's not getting all the stuff inside the coach wet. Another really cool feature about this guy is it has the Easy Flex suspension system right in here. That's gonna allow for a smooth ride. It's gonna absorb 80% of your road shock. So it's really an innovative suspension design that's like nothing else out there. Here is the new steps that they have. These are super cool. Everybody is loving these. In fact, I'll be shocked if not everybody goes to these eventually. But the reason why these are so nice is because you don't have to, if you've ever messed with the old style set of stairs, they can be finger pinchers, as well as they're not super stable. They're usually very spongy. These ones, very solid. And then the way that you have to put these up, they're aluminum and they have a helper on it, so it's spring loaded to help you get it up into the coach. And then you close the door and you're set. So very nice. Another thing before we go inside, guys, I wanted to note that this has the LED light strip all the way across. But on top of that, if you were able to see the 8 inches of the awning on top of here, it has the metal wrap on it. What happens is that white spot right close to the coach, that seems to get cracked and gets little pinholes in it over time. And that's problematic, of course, because then you have to replace your entire awning fabric, even though that's the only place that gets messed up. By having that metal awning over there, it's gonna last a lot longer. Couple other things to show you out here. One, it does have the outside speakers. This is the other side of that pass-through storage. You'll notice how thick this luggage door is and that it's the metal latch, not a plastic one that's gonna wear out pretty quick. And then, yeah, lots of room. You do have lights in here that if you want to be able to see what you're doing, you can do. This also has the storm door. So not only is it a screen door, it has this plasticky storm flap on it so that you can be able to get some light in there, some natural light, without the wind cruising through the camper. Another thing that I wanted to show you is notice how long this grab assist handle is. It sticks out bigger or longer than the normal grab assist handle. That's because of the set of stairs that you have. And the last thing that I wanted to mention to you, that's probably one of the most important things, is how this wall is built. This is a non-laminated wall. That means there's basically three walls that you can build. You can build a pinch-rolled wall, a vacuum bonded wall, which is 10 times better than a pinch-rolled wall, or a non-laminated wall. The reason why that's important is because a wall can start to get a bubble in it, and that bubble can slowly move throughout the camper because of the pressure change of that gas and moisture that gets in there, and it will just keep on moving and getting bigger and bigger until it gets to an edge, and you can have the wall just completely fall off at that point. This being a non-laminated wall, what they do is they take the fiberglass, spray it onto the wood backer, or Luon is what they call it, and that is chemically bonded, so there's no glue involved to worry about it gassing off. This wall can't delaminate compared to any other type of wall. You usually don't see this until you get into your $250,000 motorhomes. So another really good feature. And then the floor, I should mention also, is the 5/8 inch tongue and groove plywood decking, not your OSB chipboard that you see in a lot of the competition, unfortunately. Come on inside, let's check this out, guys. So this is the inside. You'll notice the opposing slide outs make a lot of room in here. Gosh, probably almost feels like a studio apartment more than a camper. Two Lazy Boy recliners, as well as the couch. All this furniture is movable, so if you wanted to be able to move this to like the center of the room, you could. Same with the couch. The table is obviously movable. Now they do put four screws in it, so it doesn't move as you're moving down the road, but those are obviously easily taken out if you want. So this is the Lazy Boy chair. It is a recliner, and that clicking noise that you hear, that is patented from Lazy Boy. So if you want your feet at a certain height, you can do that on a Lazy Boy. The other thing that you can do on a Lazy Boy that you can't do on other chairs is you can lean this part back without putting your feet up. That you will only find on a Lazy Boy. And obviously the warranty and the quality of Lazy Boys is top notch. Large LED Jensen TV, specifically designed for temperature control and vibration tested. That's important, because if the TV is not that those things, you'll have problems over time. Nice backlighting for these right here. Those are controlled just by this switch right here on the side. And lots of storage inside here. More storage down here if you need it. And then all the wood fascia on the fronts of these is real wood. So if you knock on it and it doesn't sound like real wood, you know that's a piece of composite that can break easily over time. This is a sofa sleeper. So the way this works is just like you would in any other sofa sleeper out there that you'd have probably like at your home. Although this, being a Lazy Boy, is a little bit nicer. So folds out like that. This is a little bit thicker material. It's actually got like an inner spring to it. So it's gonna be, I would dare say, a little bit more comfortable than your typical sofa sleeper. These do have storage underneath them. So if you wanted to store, you know, a deck of cards or a sewing kit, you can do that. And then on the side here, there's a thing that clips to hold this in place, but there's a leaf inside here. So if you want a little bit more elbow room as you're moving, you know, with four adults in here, you can do that. These are the slow rise type of rollers. So you pull it and there's an adjustment on this side and this side to be able to say how quickly you want that to go up and down, as well as where do you want it to stop. Over here, you'll notice this is a gas electric refrigerator. By the way, these two little clips right here, people ask me what these are for. This is to keep your refrigerator good and so that it doesn't stink the next time you go camping. So what you want to do is you don't want to have this thing closed when you're out in storage. You want to put this here and that will keep it open just a hair. That way it's not flying open as you're moving down the road, but it's also not stinking and building mold and mildew in there over time. Since this is a gas electric, that means you can run this while you're boondocking. So if you're in a place that doesn't have hookups, for instance, like if you're at the Walmart parking lot because you're on the way to somewhere and you didn't have reservations, or if you're out in the mountains and it's just, you know, there's tons of national forest out there that don't have the hookups that you can just pull off to the side of the road and camp there, that's when the type of fridge like this comes in handy. This is all flush, so you have extra counter space to work with. And then you'll notice it's the nicer grid on top of here. And then this type of material is not just wallpaper, it's like a wallboard, almost like a metal-y type of material. Large 22-inch oven. You do have some nice drawers underneath here. And you'll notice as I close these, that last inch or so, it closes on its own. That way, if you're going down the road, it gets bumped a little bit, it's not gonna come flying out and stay out. It'll kind of push itself in and keep things where they should be. You'll also notice on a Cedar Creek, since this is a non-laminated wall, the outlets are all in normal places. So in most coaches, what it is it's a piece of block foam in the middle, and then you have your inner wall panel and your outer wall panel, and those are sandwiched together. Because of that, there is no place to put wiring, because that will cause even more problems for it to delaminate. Because this is batten insulation, the same type of insulation that you would have in your home, they can do this. So you'll notice outlets all over the place in normal spots. All the hinges are hidden hinges, so they're the upgraded hinges throughout. And then also, I don't know if you'd be able to tell this or not, but if you felt behind here, you'll notice this is all pine wood that's pocket screwed together instead of stapled together. Again, what happens is, on showroom floor, it looks great, but this little seam right here, over time of you opening and closing stuff like this, gets worn out and that starts to fall apart if it's particle board just with a staple. Solid surface countertop up here, pull down sink faucet, stainless steel sink, it's split 50-50. Lots of spots to put your trash can. Lots more, 8 drawers on just this area alone. And then this is super nice too. This is the Dometic dual zone temperature thermostat. So what this works is you can work both your AC and your furnace from this deal here that's running both the living room and the bedroom. So that's super nice to be able to set the temperature and not worry about it. And the other thing that you'll like about this air conditioner is it's the Whisper Quiet air conditioner. Now there's a brand out there of Whisper Quiet air conditioner, but it's almost just as loud as all the other air conditioners. The only one that is truly quieter is when the return ducts are on the side like this. If you can see the AC box up here, that means it's going to be very noisy. I've even seen it where guys go halfway where they'll have it this setup for the living room, and then in the bedroom they have the super noisy AC, which is annoying, right? The nice thing about Cedar Creek Silverback, they do both the same way. It's the nice return ducts on the sides where the AC is actually mounted on the roof, not halfway into the coach. Right above the Dometic thermostat, you also have a manual, or remote control, I should say, for your high-powered max air, or this is actually a Creative Breeze vent fan with the rain sensor. What that means is it has a lid that will automatically open and close, and it will automatically close if it starts to rain. Also, this is all LED lights throughout the entire coach, and with that barreled ceiling, so it makes it feel bigger. Also, it wicks the rain off of your roof, as well as look how nice you have for the cathedral slide outs. So it makes use of that space way nicer than just having a flat ceiling that could potentially be a head knocker. Over here is your control panel. So remember how I was telling you there was a little monitor that you'd put in your truck? That's this right here. It works wirelessly. You just plug it right into the 12 volt system on your truck and you're ready to go. This is where you would build a controller into if you decide to add solar. So there's wires already pre-ran here so that you just have to cut this out and pop it in your set. Another cool feature that you'll like is you can not only level this coach, but you can also go through all the manuals on everything in the coach. So if you forgot how to work your 6-point auto level system or your furnace or your water heater, all those have like nice little built-in videos as well as the owner's manual to be able to figure that out. And then this is all your controls. So this is your monitor panel to tell you how full your battery is, how full your fresh tank, your black tank, your gray tanks. All those are controlled right here, built into the place that can be closed and kind of hidden out of sight. And then this guy does have the central back system. So it comes with the hose that you can reach all the way to the front, to the back, and it's all pre-built in for you. All right, come up here and I'll show you the bathroom. One of the things that they did right on this coach is they put a sliding door instead of a normal swinging door. Because you can imagine me trying to open up that swinging door either way and then trying to get into the hallway and close that door would be a pain. So putting a sliding door here makes a lot more sense than a lot of the other options. Two, you'll notice this is a porcelain commode instead of a plastic one. Again, just things that you only can appreciate once you actually have owned a coach and know the difference. Nice little linen closet here, a second high-powered Creative Breeze fan with 4 different settings on that. And then look at the size of the shower. So lots of room, you have a sitting spot, you also have plenty of headroom, natural light from the skylight. This is a 3-tiered system for the door to close so that it makes it a wider spot right here, as well as extra space here for your medicine cabinet, more space over here to put things, and then of course more storage underneath here as well. So yeah, you can't beat this bathroom. This is one of the best ones out there. This is, by the way, the King satellite, or not satellite, TV antenna, so you can just push this button to turn it to get the best TV reception. And this is the bedroom. So you'll notice I'm all the way to the very edge of the bed, and I still have lots of headroom. Try that in any other coach and you'll be ducking down, or you'll have this weird step right about here or here that you have to step up onto before you get all the way to the end of the coach. So this is the benefit of having a full profile fifth wheel. Two, you'll notice this is a king size bed, not a queen size. And this is a residential king, 70 inch by 80 inch king size bed. So that's really nice. And this is some storage that you have underneath. They have the struts kind of holding it up for you, so it's all pre-built in. You also notice this is a Serta mattress, so it's not your entry level mattress that a lot of guys use. And then back over here, there's not only some coat hooks, but it's kind of a unique spot to be able to kind of change, because there's always, you know, times when you have friends over or kids or whatever and you need a changing spot. This is perfect for that. And then as you're reading in bed or getting up in the morning, you don't have to worry about hitting this because it is the cathedral slide out. And I have control so that I can read my book over here while that person can go to sleep, or vice versa. And then you also have air that can move through here. So all of these have like a little tiny, I don't know if you can see this or not, but it's a little spot to put like your cell phone or whatever. And then these windows do open up so you can get a nice cross breeze through this way, as well as right beyond this TV. So you do have a bedroom TV up here. And then this is an emergency exit, although that would be a very tall drop if you did have to use it as an emergency exit. And then again, these have the nice closed drawers. So again, another way that people cheat is they'll put the nice drawers in the kitchen, and then once you're not looking in the bedroom, they'll put the cheap ones in. So Cedar Creek does it all the way. You also have a light inside the closet, another thing that a lot of guys leave out for whatever reason. This does have the washer dryer hookups right over here. And so you can do that, as well as some nice shelving because it has that nice bowed front cap. Yeah, so you got lots of cool options. Oh, and a couple nice drawers over here. And again, they didn't cheapen up the drawers, they're the nice ones. So if you were willing to stay with me throughout this entire video, thanks. If you could drop a like, that really helps me out a lot. Thank you very much. Also, if you want to see any more videos that I do, as well as the rest of our sales staff, you can hit the subscribe or the bell button right next to the subscribe, and that will allow you to see all the videos that we have up and coming. We're going to have some really cool ones coming up shortly, because Will, Tom, Gary, and I are all going, and Jeremy, are all going to go to the factories where they're setting up. All the factories in Indiana are actually getting together, and they're going to display all the products. We're going to go look at them all, and we'll tell you all the differences that we see, things that we're considering, all the new changes that they're going to be made. It's a big surprise, so it's a huge deal. We're going to be out there for about a week, and that's in September, I believe, so this month, so it's coming up quick. Also, if you have any questions, feel free to reach out. Our number is 970-313-4337. You can also comment down below. We'll answer you that way. Or you can reach us at email, sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Thanks, guys. Have a great day.